Cek, cek.
Yes, sir.
Oke. Okay. Oke. Okay. Okay, the topic for this afternoon is microcontroller, but we will talk about electric circuits and the basic first. So in this module, using ESP8266, IoT for a beginner. Firstly, we talk about electric circuits. If you have any question, you can directly ask me using chat or using using voice. Okay, in the chat already Arduino IDE. Okay, we talk that later. Okay. An electric circuit is a closed circuit consisting of power source, number two, device that use electrical power, or we call it load, and then conductor to connect the circuit or cable. Okay, and then we have voltage. Why does we have to have voltage? Because the current flows from high to low voltage potential. If the voltage is zero, then the current does not flow. The magnitude of the voltage, V, follows the device specification. For example, for washing machine, we need in Indonesia 220 volt AC alternating current. And then for remote controller, for example, we use 3 volt DC, direct current. Incorrect voltage cause the device to not work or even break down. So we must check the device specification, how much voltage they need in order to operate properly. Okay. And then we have resistance. Every device or every load has resistance and converts the electrical energy into another form. For example, a lamp converts electricity into light, or a washing machine converts electricity into motion using motor. And then current. Now, current will flow when the electric circuit is closed. The amount of current that flows is inversely proportional to the resistance of the device. Following the equation, current is voltage divided by resistance. And then short circuit, this is when the resistance is zero, when the power source from positive side directly connected to negative side, then we have short circuit. The current will be very high because the resistance is close to zero. The wires will be hot and can be causing fire. And then power, it is the amount of electric power. We can calculate it by multiplying the voltage by the electric current. For example, if electric iron using 220 volt needs current of 1.5 amp, then the power used is 220 multiplied by 1.5, 330 watt. Okay. This is basic definition in electrical circuit: voltage, resistance, current, and then power. The voltage, we must read the specification. So the voltage must be matched. The resistance is different for every device. High power device, the resistance is lower. And then the current we can calculate using this formula. Okay, this is the illustration. In here we have power source from battery, and then we have a load in form of lamp, and then we have a connecting conductor cable and a switch. If we have a closed circuit, the switch is closed, we have electric circuit, the lamp will be on. Okay, is there any question? If not, I will continue to the next page. Okay, for this session, we use breadboard. This is a half breadboard. And then we also have full breadboard, twice the size of this half. The breadboard is consists of two parts. The top and bottom parts is for power distribution, power rail or power bus, plus positive, minus negative, or we use plus for VCC, minus for ground. The same as in the bottom and the top. Okay, and the hole is connected horizontally for power rail. So when we connect plus in this hole, the entire hole in one row is also connected. You can see it from the bottom, and the connection is like this. When we peel the tape, you can see in the rail in the inside. And then in the middle, we have terminal strip. It is connected vertically. This is the place to for the component. You place the component in the terminal strip. Okay, the middle is disconnected by a dip. We usually place IC in the middle. Okay, you can see in the inside like this. So the terminal strip is connected vertically. You place it in one column, it is connected in the entire column, in the top or in the bottom part. Okay. In the terminal strip, there is marking for 4 row. This is 10 row, A, B, C, D until G. And then we have 30 column from the half breadboard. Okay, I'll show you the okay, and this is the half breadboard. You can also buy full breadboard. It is twice the size, like this. When you have a complex, more complex, more bigger component or circuit, you maybe need a full breadboard. Okay. Okay, we use breadboard to prototype, so we don't have to solder the component directly. It is used for prototyping. When we have the functional circuit, we replace it with the PCB. This is temporary for prototyping. Okay, any question for the breadboard? Okay, and the plus is for positive. We call it VCC in the MCU, microcontroller unit, VCC. And the minus is ground. Yeah, we call it ground for the negative, VCC for positive. This is the another term for positive and negative, VCC and ground. Okay. Okay, we move on to LED, light emitting diode. This is a diode. So if you place it incorrectly, the positive side to the negative, it will not light up. So the LED is polar. It has positive, the longer one, the longer leg, and the negative is the shorter leg. It is like this. Sorry. Okay, like this. Now this is the LED. The positive is in here, the longer leg, the long leg. And the shorter leg is negative. If you place it wrongly, the LED will not light up. Okay. Okay, LED will emit light when the current flows through it, but it needs a resistor. So you must use resistor to limit the current. Else the LED will be broken, will be burned up. LED is polar. It has positive and negative side. The longer leg is positive. The shorter one is negative. If it's the opposite, the LED will not light up. So if it is not light up, you can change the direction, positive and negative. But you must use resistor, else the LED will be broken. Okay, in this example, we will use the MCU, the microcontroller unit. We call it MCU to provide the power source. So the LED needs a voltage, direct current voltage, not from the mains power supply, from the home. So we use the board to provide the power source. Okay. We use 3.3 volt voltage from this pin. And then the negative is connected to the ground from the MCU. So in the 3.3 volt to the power bus, positive side. This is connected, dotted in green color. This connected for the entire row, and then from the positive to the LED, the longer leg, positive by using a jumper cable, and then the shorter leg is connected to resistor. Before we connect it to ground. Now, this is the circuit. So it is looping from 3.3 volt to the LED through the resistor and then go back to ground. This one circuit. Okay, and the resistor value is usually 220 or 330 ohm. But you can use another value. If it is greater value, then the light will be dim because the current will be low, so the light will be dim. Okay, and this is the connect action table 3.3 to the plus LED, and then ground to the minus of the LED via resistor. Okay, don't forget to add the resistor. You can use 5 volt to power the LED. The LED will be brighter. But in this example, we use 3.3. Okay, let's try this example. Okay, I use Wemos D1 Mini. You can use Wemos D1 R2. The pin is slightly different, but the same. You can see this 3.3 volt and then ground. 3.3 positive, ground negative. Or you can use node MCU. Yeah, this is the same pin, but the position is different. 3.3 and then ground. Okay, for the practice, I will use this D1 Mini, and then we need LED. Don't forget the long leg is positive. You can place it everywhere as long as different column. Sorry. For the positive and negative. You can place it here, doesn't matter. Positive, negative. Okay. I will check the module. It is placed in about here. Okay, and then you need resistor, any resistor, as long as higher than 200 ohm. This is 220. The higher the resistance, the LED will be dimmer. Okay, and the resistor connected to the shorter leg to the negative. This is positive, the long leg, short leg negative, connected to resistor to ground to negative. Okay, and then we connect it to the MCU. The MCU is not programmed yet. We only use it to provide power source. 3.3 to positive. Like this, 3.3 to the power rail, positive. And then we connect the power rail, positive power rail to the positive of the LED, and then finally we connect the ground from the MCU to the power rail. Nah. Okay, the LED is already light up. If the LED is not light up, maybe you can try to try in the opposite direction. Okay, don't forget to connect to the USB power source. The MCU get the power source from the USB. Okay, sorry, did you see my my breadboard, or it is still showing the document?
Sorry, sir. I just see your Google Docs.
Okay. Sorry. How it is? Okay, can you see my breadboard?
No.
Sorry, sir. I didn't have it.
Okay. Maybe it's...
Sorry, sir. Maybe you can unshare screen.
Yeah.
And you will share screen again.
Okay, it's better. Can you see my breadboard? Okay, I will repeat the process. Okay, did you see the breadboard? Check.
Yes, sir.
Okay, and this is the LED. It has two legs. The long is positive. The short one is negative. You can place it everywhere in the terminal strips as long as in the different column. You don't connect it in the same column because the positive and negative will be connected like this. It will not work. So place it everywhere in the breadboard in the different column. I will follow the module. I will choose this column, positive and negative in different column. Okay, and then don't forget to add the resistor. I usually use 220 ohm. You can check it using multimeter because the color is too difficult to read. You can read it using color actually. Okay. From the negative side of the LED, connect it in the negative rail. Like this, and then we power it using the MCU. We use the MCU to get the power source. We don't program it yet. So the positive is 3.3 volt. Then the power rail, positive power rail, like this. And then from the power rail, we connect it to the positive of the LED, like this. If you have longer cable, you can also directly turn the 3 volt, but my cable is shorter, so I use the help of power bus, like this. Hey. Okay, and lastly, connect it to ground. From the resistor, connect it to ground to the MCU. There you have it. The LED is light up. Okay, any problem? Do you have any problem? The column number doesn't matter as long as the connection is correct. You can place it in the middle. Like this. then you connect it to the positive power bus and connect it to the ground using resistor. Okay. Or maybe you use this one, this port. If you are using this port, you power it through USB and then you take the power source from the board in 3.3 and then the ground. Using Wemos D1 board. If you have this board. Okay, please try this. If you have any problem, write it in the chat or ask it directly. Okay, Miss Sri Murniani using Walkwi. Okay, if you don't have the hardware yet, you can use simulation walkwi.com. And then you can scroll to the start from scratch. Okay, you can use many MCU, Arduino or ESP. I think you should use ESP because this is the most similar to ESP8266. Okay, like this. This is ESP32. Hey. Zoom in. Okay. Okay. This is ESP32, and then you add component in this plus button, add component. We want to add LED like this. You can change the color because this is simulation. And then you connect the positive to 3.3. Click. And then click 3.3. You can change the color. Usually for VCC, it is red. VCC, positive power, red. And then the ground is black. This is the convention. Because when you mix up the VCC and ground, you could broke the device. This is black. Okay, and then you can simulate by play. press the play button. Oh, we forgot to resist the current. In the real world, this LED will be broken, will be burned up. Okay, then stop the simulation. We add the resistor. Okay, maybe I will delete this part. Delete this part. The resistor position is upward. Okay, there. Okay, negative to resistor, and then from resistor to ground. The negative is black, negative is black. Okay, simulate. Okay. This is using WOKWI. We use ESP32MCU in WOKWI. And to change the value of the resistor, you can go to diagram tab, WOKWI resistor, we can change the value. 220 red brown. Okay, this is using simulation. Okay, any question from the LED for this? Everybody can do it correctly. If yes, then I will continue. Okay. Okay, and then we continue using button. Button is used to cut off the current. So the current flow will be cut in this button. If the button is pressed, then the current will flow and the LED will be light up. Okay. Back to the breadboard. This is the LED that we use. And then this is momentary switch button. It will not toggle, but momentary. So you should push it to activate the button. It will be back momentarily. So you place the button in the middle. Okay, like this. Maybe for the beginner, it is difficult to place it. So this is the orientation of the button. The button will be connected from the right side and the left side if the button is pressed. Okay, so it is placed vertically. like this, place it in the middle of the breadboard. Okay. Okay, when the button is pressed, the right side will be connected to the left side. Okay, because the current is interrupted, so we must add another cable from the negative side to the button. So we add another cable from the negative of the LED to the button, the right side of the button. And then from the left side of the button connected to the ground, to resistor. Okay, in order to light the LED, we need to push the button. Okay. Okay, please try yourself. If there is any difficulties, ask question in the chat or directly. Okay. If you sing. Okay, sing the one. Okay. Using the one is the same, yeah. So you only need different power source using this port. Then the negative is to ground. This is ground. And then positive to 3.3. And then you power the D1 board. Okay, so ground to negative power rail, 3.3 to positive power rail, the rest is the same. You must push the button to light the LED. This type of button is momentary switch button. So when you release it, it will be back to disconnected. There is also a type of button, toggle switch. When you push it once, it will stay on. To put it off, you must push it once again. So there is a different type of button. Okay. And for those who use simulator, you can add the button component. Any push button. One R, one H2R. Okay. The button connecting R to L, right to left. Okay. I will delete this and connect it to the right, and then from the left connect it to the resistor. This is awkward. The cable is automatic, so I cannot change. Okay. The resistor. Okay. Then simulate, and then press the button. Now, this is a momentary switch push button.
Sorry, Pak Aurita, I have some difficulty because my LED is not working. So
Yeah.
the positive, the negative of the LED. Can you show me again about the LED, how to?
Okay.
Sorry. Thank you.
Okay, when the LED is not working, you should check the polarity of the pin. The longer leg is positive. It is connected to the positive power bus. Positive power bus to the longer leg. And the shorter leg is negative. You should connect it to the negative power bus. Okay, I will make it wider so you can see it. Okay, this is the positive, the longer leg. It is connected to the positive power bus. And then the negative is connected to the negative power side using resistor. Okay, did it solve your problem?
Working on it.
Okay.
Thank you.
Okay, you can check it directly without using button. The resistor directly to the ground. If this is working correctly, then you can add the button. Okay. Okay, Miss Sri Murniani, this is the push button. Did you try it?
Yes, yes. It
Okay.
was working. Yeah.
Okay.
I'm good. I'm good. Thank you, sir.
You're welcome. Okay, so the connection table is like this. From the MCU, we take 3.3 volt to the LED, the long leg positive, and then from the LED negative to the button one, the pin one, or pin area, the right pin, and then from the button, the left pin, we connect it to the ground via resistor. When the button is pressed, the circuit is closed. Okay, is there any problem? Okay, if not, we will continue to the MCU. Okay, we use ESP8266. It has digital pin. It operates at 3.3 volt.
Ini mati enggak, Pak?
Okay. Okay, we continue. Okay, it consists of three parts. The power parts, we have 5 volt, 3.3 volt, and then ground. And then we have digital input output, or GPIO, general purpose input output. We have pin D0 through D8. Please mute the participant, please. Committee. Okay. Okay, let's continue. For the digital I/O, we have 11 pin. D0 to D8, TX and RX. It used for communication, analog output, and general purpose I/O. For communication, we have serial UART, serial communication to the PC using pin TX and RX. So we don't use this pin. It is used for communication to the PC. And then we have I2C communication for the sensor device. And we have SPI communication, serial peripheral interface. It is used for higher rate communication, such as micro SD card. And lastly, we have analog input. For the ESP8266, we only have one analog input, A0. Okay, and this is the layout for the D1 Mini. The power pin is 3.3, 5 volt and ground. And then the digital pin is D0 through D8 plus RX and TX. And then we have one analog pin. Okay, in the bottom, the layout for VMOS D1 R2, we have digital pin in the right side, RX, TX, D0 through D8. And in the upper part, it is duplicated for D1, D2, This is I2C communication, SDA, SCL. And then the 5 through the 8, this is for SPI communication. Okay, in the left side, we have power 3.3, 5 volt, ground, and V-in. V-in, when you connect it to the USB, V-in is 5 volt, the same as this 5 volt. And then we have one analog input, A0. SDA, SCL, this is D1 and D2. This is duplicate. Okay. For Node MCU, this is also the same. If you use Node MCU, the layout may be slightly different, but you have this D0 from D0 to D8, and then RX, TX. And we have one analog input, A0. The rest is power pin, 3.3, ground. 3.3 ground, this is duplicated, and then V-in. And the pin is the same, only the layout is slightly different. Okay, by the way, this is the ESP8266, this IC. Okay, this is the IC, ESP8266. Also, the board is larger like this. The core IC is just this one, the ESP8266. This layout is imitating the Arduino, this famous D1 R2. Okay. For ESP32, the layout is different. If you want to use this guide, you should check in the last page. Now, this is the conversion table. For example, if I use D4 in the ESP8266, then you should use pin number 2 in the ESP32 in the simulation. Pin number 2, this D2, pin number 2. Because the numbering is different for ESP32. Okay, any question for the pin? Pin out. Okay, not yet. And then we continue to IDE installation. So to install Arduino IDE, we program the MCU using Arduino IDE. You must download the Arduino IDE in this link. This is for Windows. If you use Ubuntu Linux, you can install it using sudo apt install Arduino. You can install it by using this command. Okay, let me check the okay, Ubuntu 22.04 failed at step 2. Okay, this guide is for Windows, yeah. So this is the link for Windows. If you want to install Arduino IDE in Ubuntu, you can use repository like this, sudo apt install Arduino. and then wait until it is finished, or you can download the latest Arduino software from arduino.cc. Arduino.cc software. This is for Windows. The link is the same in the guide. And then this is for Linux if you want to install manually. But I suggest you use a repository. This is easier for Ubuntu. Okay. Okay, I will continue the installation process. Okay, I assume you already installed the Arduino. And then we must add the support for ESP8266. So open your IDE, Arduino IDE. Okay, like this. And then go to File, Preferences, search for additional boards, additional boards manager URL, and then copy and paste this link. This is the link to download the ESP8266 support. Copy to here. Click OK. So File, Preferences, and then additional boards manager URL. Copy paste to this text box, then click OK. Okay. Next, tools, and then board manager. This the menu is crowded. Tools, board, and then boards manager. Okay, scroll to the bottom, find ESP8266. In my PC, it is already installed. This is the status install. If it is not installed, click in button in the below. Click install. For example, like this, this is not installed yet. Click install. Okay. If it is successfully installed, maybe you have to wait a while to download the board definition. And then you can select the ESP8266 board like this. Now, if you use Wemos, you select Lolin Wemos D1, R2, and Mini. Or if you use NodeMCU, select the NodeMCU 1.0 in the board. Okay, the list is crowded, long. So please find if you use Wemos. Please find board and then ESP8266, Lolin, Wemos, D1, R2, and Mini. Okay. Okay, and then test it by plugging it, plugging in the Wemos board to USB and select the communication port. Okay, tools port. Okay, in Linux, it is named dev.tty USB 0. In Windows, it is named com a number, com 3, com 4, com 5. Please select the serial port. Okay. So please select the board. Lolin Wemos D1R2 and Mini. And then make sure the port is not grayed out. It is active. If not, check the connection to the USB. Please connect it to the USB. And then we are ready to go. To test it, you can upload example program. File examples, and then the basic Blink. This is the Blink program. This is the program. To upload, press the upload button in the toolbar. Click upload. Okay, and then this is already complete. You can check the MCU. It should be blinking like this. 1 second on, 1 second off. Okay, please try it yourself and then I will check the chat if there is any problem. Okay, did anyone encounter full port gray out? Maybe you should add yourself to the dial out group. So try sudo add user your username to the dial out because we use the serial communication port. You can check your ID. ID this is my ID. You should be in the dial out group, this group. So you can add yourself to dial out group by this comment. So do add group. Like this. Or using the variable user, your current username. sorry, my comment is wrong. Sudo add group user dial out. It should be def tty usb. Def tty acm is for Arduino. Okay, maybe the OS is still new, yeah. Ubuntu 22. So this is already many problem that user has reported for Ubuntu 22. And this is maybe should be work for you. Okay, maybe. Okay, please try it. I hope it will solve your problem. Okay. For Windows user, any problem? I will wait for you to install the Arduino IDE. If there is any problem, send it in the chat. We will have a break, a 10 minutes break. So we will be back 14:20. I will stand by for those of you who has successfully installed, you can take a break, 10 minutes. Okay, we continue again. Any problem that you face for installing the IDE plus support for ESP8266? Okay, I will continue to the programming using IDE. Okay, for the first program, the Blink, this is the first example program for Arduino. We will talk about the programming construct. So and the basic structure of Arduino program is consisting of two functions. The first one is setup, and the second one is loop. These two functions must be exist in the program. So setup will be run only once in the beginning, setup, and the loop will be run continuously. So in the function of the MCU is to run the our program continuously in this loop function. Okay, in the first program, we will make the LED blink like the test program in this example, but we will blink the external LED. So the board have built-in LED. Okay, and the board has built-in LED, this blue LED. This is connected to pin D4. So if we control the pin D4, we can control the built-in LED. So the schematic is like this. We connect the pin D4 to the positive of the LED. So the power is provided by digital pin. The digital pin can provide current up to 12 milliamps. So it can be used to light the LED, to operate the LED. And as always, we use resistor to limit the current to the ground, connected to the ground. Okay, for the programming, we use digital write function on pin D4 to set the output of this pin to high or low. Because it is digital, the output is only 2. 0 or 1, high or low. High is 1, low is 0. And the duration of the blink will be controlled by using delay function. The parameter is in milliseconds. So if we want to blink it 1 second, we fill with the 1000 millisecond. Okay. The program is like this. This is the same as the example program in the Blink. This is more complicated with comment. So this is the setup function. We set the default pin to output mode using function pin default to output. And then in the loop function, we set it to high, turn on the LED using digital write pin default to high, turn on the LED. We turn it on for 1 second. So we will delay for 1 second, 1000 millisecond. And then we turn it off using digital write pin default to low. Turn off for 1 second, delay 1 second. Okay, you can use any pin from D0 to D8 to control the LED using digital write. The TXRX pin is not used because it is used for serial communication. When you upload the program to the MCU, it is using pin TX and RX. When you upload from the USB, will be converted to serial, and then from the serial to the MCU to upload the program. So we will not use this pin TX RX. Okay. So the schematic is we use the D4 to control the LED. So we connect the pin D4 to the positive side of the LED. We don't use the button. The LED could be closer to this. Okay, and then the D4 to the positive of the LED. Okay, like this. Okay, if you see the LED is in the opposite because the built-in LED is active low. When we write low, the LED will be light up, will be active. The built-in LED is active low. So in the opposite of the regular LED. This LED is active high. When we put high to D4, the LED will be light up. The built-in LED is the opposite. This is active low. So when you set high, the built-in LED will turn off the opposite. Okay. Okay, you can try it in the simulation also. Connect to D2 for ESP32. And then you can experiment the delay. Maybe you want to speed up the delay. So I will copy this code to the Arduino IDE. Every time you change the code, you must upload to the MCU. For example, I want the faster blink. The delay for half a second. the comment is not. Okay, this. And then upload to the MCU. Before you upload, you must save it to a file, an Arduino project. Okay, this is the uploading process. Wait it until 100% writing to MCU, and then the MCU will be reset. This is okay, path resetting via RTS pin to reset the MCU, and then you can check the result. Okay. The LED will be blink faster.
Okay.
Yes.
Sorry. After we put, we write the coding in the sketch.
Yes.
Here. What should we do?
We should upload.
Upload.
Click upload. Click upload and then wait the code to be uploaded to the MCU until 100% and reset, and then you can check it the result in the MCU, how the MCU behave. Okay, this is the basic program of Arduino. You must have these two functions, setup and loop. And then in this program, there is a new function, pin mode, to set the mode of the pin. This can be output or input. For this example, we want to set it to output to light the LED. And then in the loop function, we use digital write function to the specific pin. For digital write, we can only set it to state high or low. Now, high, this will turn on the LED, and low will turn off the LED. But some device is active low, so this device is the opposite. If you want to turn it on, you set it to low, and if you want to turn it off, you set it to high. Okay, and this is depending on the device, whether active high or active low, to turn it off or turn it on. And then the function delay, the parameter is in millisecond. Okay, after the last line, the program will be loop to this line, the first line of the loop function. This will be loop forever. This will be loop forever until the MCU is turned off. Okay. Any question? I will try the simulator using ESP32. Okay, we change the pin for D4 is pin number D4. it for number two. So from pin number two to the positive side of the LED. Okay, and then you can program it in this sketch. Set up a spin mode. Pin number two as output. Zoom in. I cannot zoom in. Zoom this in. Sorry. Zoom in. Okay. Okay, for ESP32, you only write the pin number, number two, and then set it to high, and then set it to low using digital write. Digital write pin number two to high, and then delay. And then set it to low. Start the simulation, click play. Okay, you also have the built-in LED in this ESP32. It seems that the built-in LED is also active high. So when you set it high, the LED turn on. The same as the external LED. This the blue LED is built-in LED. Okay, don't forget to stop the simulation, because it will use your computation power for simulating the ESP32.
Pak Riza, can you show us using the D1?
Using the D1, okay.
Thank you.
Okay, using the D1 first, I will upload the sketch to the D1. Port. The port is gray out. Okay, connected. Upload. Okay, it is uploaded. The LED will blink, and the connection to breadboard, we connect the LED positive to D4, pin D number 4, pin. Okay, and then the negative to ground. You can also get the ground pin in here. This is also ground. Okay, for ESP8266, the built-in LED, the blue, is active low. So the light is the opposite. Okay, any problem for the first program? The full reference is in this link, arduino.cc reference. What is the function? What is the variable? High, low, and then the mode, input, output. Input pull up, we will use this using button input pull up, and then there is LED built in, we have used digital write, this function, and pin mode function, and delay. The structure is setup function, and then loop function. Setup and loop. The rest of the language is based on C++. So if you have basic in the C language or C++, this is must be easy. Should be easy. Okay, and this is the documentation. Digital write, pin mode. There is three mode, input, output, and input pull up. And then delay in millisecond. Then setup function and loop function. Okay, let's continue to our second program using potentiometer. The LED is output, one of the output. We can send the MCU status using LED. For example, if the connection is bad, the blinking is slow. If the connection is good, the blinking is fast. We can use the LED to output the status. And in this potentiometer, we use it as input. In the value between 0 and 1023. Okay, before that, I will show the potentiometer. One of the form is like this. Like this. This is the small one. You can read it 103. So this is maximum 10,000. 10,000 multiply by 10 to the power of 3. So 10000. This is 10,000 kilo ohm, 10,000 ohm, 10 kilo ohm. Okay, the middle pin is variable. We can change the resistance value using the knob. Usually knob, or when the potentiometer is small, we use screwdriver to turn the knob. For the bigger potentiometer, Excuse me. Okay, and this is the bigger potentiometer. Like this, we usually attach the knob to turn the potentiometer. The value is 10K, 10 kilo ohm. Okay, it is used to control the volume. Usually to control the volume in the radio or in the tape to control the value, the volume. Okay. Okay, potentiometer is variable resistor with three pins. Middle pin acting as voltage divider. So we can read the voltage using MCU. The value is varying by turning the knob. The output of potentiometer is a voltage value between 0 and maximum of VCC. So if we use 3.3 volt like this, the output is in this middle pin between 0 and 3.3 volt. Okay, we can read the value using analog input. In this case, A0. The reading result has 10-bit resolution. So the value will be between 0 to 123. 0 is for 0 volt, 123 is the maximum, 3.3 volt. Okay, and this is the schematic. So the potentiometer is nonpolar. We can connect the VCC or ground in the opposite direction. It is not a problem. And we will read the middle pin. The middle pin will be read using pin A0. And then we will print the value using serial communication. We will print in the PC. So let's build the schematic first. I will use the okay, and this is the potentiometer. I place it in the middle of the breadboard, three pin vertically like this. So the flat side is in the top or below. This is in the below, in the bottom. Okay, if you use the bigger potentiometer, it is easier to plug in the breadboard. You must plug it deeper because the pin is bigger. Okay. Okay, and then we connect the potentiometer to the power source. Three point three to the right. And ground to the left. Okay, like this. And this is not connected, sorry. If you put it in here, it is not connected to the bottom side. So you must connect it to the bottom part. Positive, negative, it is exchangeable. You can put it like this because the resistor is non-polar. But the output is different. The output is the opposite. If you turn it to the left, this will be maximum. If you turn it to the right, this will be minimum to zero. So the output will be the opposite. Okay, I will place it like this. If I turn it to the right, will be maximum to the 3.34. If I turn it to the left, will be minimum. Okay, to read the value, we use analog pin A0 in the middle pin. We read this value to A0. Okay, and then you can change the middle pin value by turning the knob. Okay, go back to the guide. Oh, we use the LED to show the difference. We read the value and then we put it to the delay. So we control the blinking speed by using potentiometer. Okay, I will install again the LED. The LED to D4. Connect it through a resistor to the ground. And then from ground to... Okay, in the mini, there is only one ground pin. So I will put it to the negative bus so I can share it with other component. Okay, this is the hardware setup. Okay, and this is still the old blinking program. So once you upload the program will be there until you upload the new program. Okay, and then we upload the program. This is the program. We will use serial communication. Using this line in the setup, serial begin. This is the speed, 115,200 bit per second. This is the connection speed. And then pin mode, D4 for output. And in the loop function, for every time, we will read the value of A0 potentiometer value using analog read function. The value will be from 0 to 1023, the value. And we can check it by print to the serial output. Serial print, this is print line. So we print the value and then print new line. One line of value. And then we also output it to the LED by varying the delay using value that we get from the potentiometer. Okay, let's try this sketch. You can file a new sketch, or I will just paste it here, replacing the old program. Okay, like this, and then click upload. Okay, leaving, hard resetting via RTS pin, this is okay, no problem. And this is okay. So after the program is uploaded to the MCU will be reset automatically. This is okay. And we can check in the serial monitor. So let's go back to the guide. We can check the output using serial monitor in the IDE. The serial monitor is in the right part, right upper serial monitor. Or you can search it through the menu, tools, serial monitor. Click serial monitor. And you must change the data rate if it is not correct to 115/200 baud. Okay. This is the output. Okay, and then you can turn the potentiometer to change the output. Turn to the left will be lower, close to zero. Turn to the right will be higher, close to 124. Okay, and the maximum is 124. Okay, I will show you in the LED blink. Okay, turn to the left, the blinking will be faster. We cannot differentiate if it is blinking or not because it is too fast for our eyes. And turn in to the right, the blinking will be slower. The maximum is 124 milliseconds for the delay. This is half a second. This is, let's check in the monitor, 200 milliseconds. Okay, any problem for this potentiometer?
Cool.
Anyone can show their works if it is working correctly. Anyone want to share your works?
Sir, it was working because I use simulator. It was working for the lead, and then right now I'm trying using the potentiometer.
Okay.
So I'm still trying to design that first, and then yeah, and then the code, and then. Try to simulate to see the result.
Okay, using simulator. I also new in this simulator. So, what we call potentiometer. Okay, like this. And then ground to ground, click. PCC to 3.3. Okay, for ESP, the VCC must be 3.3 because the analog input is limited to 3.3 volt. And then signal to VP. For analog input, you can use VP in this ESP32.
Oh yeah, so that's why it's not doesn't work just of that.
You can consult the conversion table.
Ah, okay.
And then the code is the same. You must change the pin. Pin to lock it. Six. Okay, the serial output is in the bottom part. You can turn the knob in the potentiometer to change the output. Okay, for the ESP32, the analog input is more precise. This is 12 bit, so the value will be from 0 to 4095, 0 to 4000. So the analog input is more precise in the ESP32. You can differentiate 4000 values. Okay. I also see slight potentiometer. This is the same. You can slide it. to make it work. The pin is VCC, signal, ground. And the pin is slightly different. VCC, ground, signal. Signal to analog input. This is light potentiometer. Okay, and the cable is automatic. Make it clear. Okay, in the chat, when we upload the module, ESP will run the module even if we close Arduino apps. Yes, even if we close the Arduino IDE, the ESP will be run if it is powered. So the program is burned to the flash memory. So it will be run independently, whether we open the IDE or not. So you can upload the program and then connect it to the USB charger maybe. So it will run independently. But if you want to get serial output like this, you must connect it to the PC for you to see the output from the serial communication.
Lisa, I have a question.
Yes.
If we run the Arduino and there is a blink in our D1, but the LED in the breadboard is not blink, what's the problem?
The built-in LED, is it blinking or not?
Sorry?
The built-in LED, is it blinking or not?
Blinking.
Blinking, but the external LED is not.
Yeah.
It is connected to pin D4.
The positive one is to D4 and the negative is at the resistor, right?
Yeah.
And then the resistor will be connected to the ground.
The ground. Maybe you can change the polarity. Maybe it is in the wrong polarity.
Okay,
we will have a break for 20 minutes until 15:30. We will have a break until 15. Okay, so take your time to rest. Don't forget to stand up and walk. Okay, we'll meet again in 20 minutes.
Okay, thank you, Mr.
Knowledge
and the direction in practice. Now, before continuing with the second practice, we will take a refreshment break first, so that we can get excited or motivated again during the second practice. Refreshment break will be held until a half past three. Participants are welcome to rest first, and don't forget to fill the attendance links. See you at a half past three. Bye.